Our text, Romans 4, verse 16. Therefore, it is of faith that it might be according to grace. Our heading, a common faith. Yes, beloved, and our faith is also common. It is the same faith in two respects. First, because we believe the same truths, and secondly, because we believe them with like precious faith. There is no dispute or discussion among us about the fundamentals of our faith. First, to us, there is one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. To us, there is one mediator, Jesus Christ the Savior. We believe in the election of grace by the Divine Father. We believe in the vicarious sacrifice of the Eternal Son. We believe in the regenerating work of the Holy Spirit and in the need of it in the case of every living man and woman and child. We believe in one Lord, one faith, one baptism. I feel intensely grateful for this unity of faith. Second, knowing, as we do, that the Scriptures are our unerring guide, that the Holy Spirit is the infallible explainer of the Scriptures. We come to one common conclusion to learn that we are to receive, and we do receive it with one common anointing, even the anointing of the Spirit of God. Then, Paul says that he and Titus were one after the common faith. That is, the one faith was believed by them in the same way. There is only one faith worth having. Paul calls it, in the first verse of Titus 1, the faith of God's elect. It is a real faith, cordial faith, childlike faith, God-given faith. It is not a faith that springs out of human nature unaided by the Holy Spirit, but it is a precious faith, faith which is the gift of God and the work of the Holy Spirit. Now, if we believe only intellectually, we do not enter into sympathy with one another, as we do when we both believe spiritually with heart and soul, from the very depth of our being. Application. Your faith may be as a grain of mustard seed, and your friend's faith may have grown into a tree, but it is the same faith. It clings to the same Christ and will produce the same eternal results in the salvation of the soul. And I pray, Father God, thank you for your grace, for the gift of faith, and that we can believe according as we are drawn by the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen.